Oh, hello, integrals and differentials. It's Donald. Welcome back to my kitchen. And on today's menu, I'll be serving you something a bit lighter, because you've probably seen lots of EX decks in the past weeks, and there's still many more we have to do, but this time around, let's use no EX Pokemons and a card we haven't done before, Aegislash, with a unique, painful sword attack. I'm going to explain to you how this deck works, and you're going to see it in a bunch of awesome, awesome matches. So, let's get started. All right. Now, Aegislash, what's your deal? So this sword, it's a little weird that it's trying to protect itself with a shield, because you know sword is for offense, so I guess it must be the smartest sword in the world. Now, his deal is he loves to multiply things by two. I mean, he multiplied himself by two when he was a Honedge, but now he likes to multiply damage counters. Painful sword. Double the damage counters on each of your opponent Pokemon. Sounds great, fantastic, but we got to get the damage on there. How do we do that? Now, of course, maybe he has something to do with himself. Negaton Slash, 100 damage, okay. 10 damage to two of your opponent's bench Pokemon. That's really little. And man, that takes four energies? I mean, we can cut it down to three with the right cards, which we will, but that's not that spectacular. You can find legendary Pokemons with these sort of stats, so this is not what we're gonna use. Although we can if it comes to that, which you'll see. So we are gonna use the richest tree in the world, who's made of completely 24 karat gold. It is Trevenant gold break, and he can use the silent fear attack, which you put three damage counters on all your opponent's Pokemon. Okay, so that's a lot of damage counters spread out through all their Pokemon, and after a couple times, 30, 60 damage, and by that time, Aegislash is going to become the better card. So, you multiply 60 by 2, that's 120. Not quite there, but how about 90? Use Silent Fear three times, follow up with Painful Sword, EX Pokemons will go down, which you may see. Okay, so it so happens that his previous evolution is extremely useful. Now this time around, he's a really bad security guard at an airport. Not sure what they're called, but they're the guys who check your items which you can bring onto a plane. He doesn't let you bring any items whatsoever. Actually, just only your opponent. Because, you know, he's on your team, of course. You can bring a sword, a shield on the plane, it's okay, but for your opponent, they can't play any items. As long as he's on duty. So he has to be in the active Pokemon, he has to be on the job, and that will ruin many, many games. And many powerful decks cannot withstand Trevenant being in front early. You will see that. Now, he also possessed quite a strong attack. Tree Slam, 60 damage. Okay, that's better than Trevenant Break, but you do 20 damage to two of your opponent's bench Pokemon, which is not as good. But if you need to get rid of the active, use this. Alright, and to make him get him out there faster. When he's in training, he can use Ascension and automatically go into Trevenant, which is really nice when it's your second turn. And by that time, oh, Forest Curse, they're screwed. Now, I do mention that also Dewblades has this very unique attack, False Swipe, which is sometimes useful. It's on a coin flip. Flip a coin, if tails, nothing, but if heads, your opponent's active Pokemon goes down to one hit point left, which means any attack will knock it out. Which is dangerous if they're using a Mega Pokemon, tough EX Pokemons, although we're not going to be able to use it as often, because it only has 80 hit points. You can't use that attack as an Aegislash, but it would be awesome. And you need a Trick Coin, which I'm not going to put in. Anyways, moving on. Our last Pokemon, of course, is Sushi Master, because, you know, you're on a budget, you got to go for, you know, just grocery food. You can't eat out. So, Sushi Master will make you some home cooking. And Abyssal Hand. Draw until you have five cards, which is useful if you have less few cards in your hand. How are we going to do that? We're going to run plenty of items, level balls and evil sodas, which is pretty much our evolution lines we talked about. Burn all the items off your hand and just draw more cards. And the unique item we're going to be using is the bursting balloon, which is kind of like a bomb, because if your opponent attacks a Pokemon that has this, they take 60 damage. And man, Painful Sword double that, 120 damage. Which is not what we're going to use it for, but add on to all the damage coming through, this thing can hurt. We're running four of them, because you have to discard this thing after it's over, because this is a really powerful item. But that gives your opponent a chance, you know, hey, I'm just not going to attack your Pokemon. Which is really big. If they don't, you may stay alive around a lot longer. But if they do, well, that sucks for them, and because you can use this up to seven times. We got four of them. So if they get this, you know, you only use it once a turn, that's okay. We're not using the Super Rod. We're using the other thing, the Eco Horn, which gets three Pokéjoules back. So seven of these, you know, this card is no problem whatsoever. All right, rest of the deck. And yes, I'm using plenty of Pokemons and energy, so if they go in discard, there's a quick way to get them back. Now, I need to set up my Pokemons quickly, so Bridget is going to be one of the best starting supporters. Get out your Honeds, get Judge of Phantoms. We're going to use Birch, four of them, because he works pretty well with Octillery. Heads, great. Tails, it's okay. And yeah, and I can't afford to discard too many cards, too many evolution lines, so forth. So this is why I'm only using two Ultra Balls and just the rest level one Evo Sodas. Sometimes I do need the discard stuff, so that's why I put some there. I could have gone all four line, but you're gonna see me with maybe with Bridget that I don't need them on. Moving on, I've got Skyla, because sometimes you just need to pick the right trainer. You need to pick up your stadium. You need to pick the right item. Oh, stadium! All your psychic Pokemons attack for one less energy. So, hey, one energy attack, two energy attack, and even a one double colorless energy attack. Although this thing really needs three somehow, which kind of sucks. Anyways, now, I thought I might go against a dark deck. Luckily, I didn't, but all your Pokemons are weak to dark. All my Pokemons are weak to dark, so I want to put up a fight. So we put one weakness policy, so one lucky Pokemon isn't going to get instantly KO'd. So yeah. Special energy, mystery energy on a psychic Pokemon reduces their retreat cost by two. Unfortunately, they all have three, so they must pay one retreat, which isn't too bad. Hey, maybe you can stick it on a Honedge, bring it home, which is something that you're gonna see me pull off. Now, this is pretty much the deck. Use Trevenant, item lock them, put damage counters on everybody, and finish it off with an Aegislash. Okay, let's see how that works. Let's start off with Mewtwo. Here we go. You know, in Kalos, of all the ghost types, I think Trevenant is the most coolest looking. Even Aegislash, because nothing, it's not really a ghost. It's a sword and a shield, right? Is this a ghost? No, but Trevenant, you're the coolest looking one. Okay, now, welcome to another Trevenant match, and let's see what's going on. Sky, oh, is this Rayquaza? Sky Rayquaza? He put an energy on, discarded, I see, because you can get it back with Bronzor. None this thing, he still has to evolve it. Six more cards, that's plenty of energies down there. Oh, this is the Mewtwo version. Okie doke. That gear, yeah, play all. Actually, I don't know if he knows I can item lock him yet. Well, he's gonna know now. So, let's go ahead, you know, put this energy on, discard the stadium. And now we, Sushi Master's right there. Huh? We must,
know what? I'm going to toss Birch and Aegislash. Birch is so-so, but Aegislash is critical. Well, Aegislash we can get back. With the Super Rod, we'll fish it out of the discard. So, now I'm going to show my true colors by retreating. And Skyla is the card I'm going to play, because that's going to be my level ball. Oh, please. Ooh. Ooh. Luckily, they're all prize. And this is going to go for Sushi Master. So, Sushi Master. There we go. When Octillery, Sushi Master's on the bench, we will for sure at least have drop power every single turn. So, now, the Iron Lock is in effect. He has Bronzor out in front. And hopefully we can overtake this Mewtwo before it charges up. Okay, so, gotta replace the stadium. Okay, so you've used up two Sky Fields. I've used up one of my Dimension Valley, and Sycamore was in your hand. Drats. Oh dear, one Brazong is up, two of them are up, and this means this Mewtwo is gonna get plenty of energy, so he just needs the Mega Mewtwo card. He doesn't even need a Spirit Link. He can just load it on, and that's that. But luckily, they are weak to Psychic. Yeah, so Sushi Master, I so hope you can cook me up something amazing. Now, the retreat cost of this thing is one. Oh, Mega Mewtwo's out. Okay, well, we have Sushi Master and Birch came along to right after. So two sources of draw power, so let's see what we can get. Hopefully a stadium, but that's fine too. And let's see, we got Trevenant Break, so all we need is an energy. So I'm gonna go ahead and toss you up. Now level ball, yeah, let's go ahead and play it. I'm definitely gonna get dual blades, this is meaningful. And now I just need energy to start the fun. So here we go. I still need the stadium. So, it's all up to Birch. Birch, do you love me? And he's like, no, I don't, Donald. Well, what can you do? I'm just gonna go ahead and dump all my items down and end my turn, because that's all you can do. Now, what? How much damage are you at? A lot. Four energies. And Aegislash is down. The other Aegislash, the one that's immune to energies. Oh, that disabled my item lock. You still need at least an energy or something to retreat. So, let's see. Maybe that last card's a Verse Seeker, perhaps? No, it can't be. You played. Oh, okay. I have more time. Time was very wonderful. Okay, I just need a stadium. So, head's perfect. Okay, so I have an evil soda here, which is not gonna be much use to me. Gonna go ahead, dump this on. And I see I have a Trevenant, so why not we just get another Phantom Pound? That makes sense. And what else? Oh, Evil Soda. This should work for Octillery. Nope, it was for Aegislash. Forgot it. Just threw him down. Come on, Donald. Okay. That is up. We'll throw up Phantom. And you get another free turn. He needs an energy or something to retreat with. I really just want to keep Bronzor here. Because, hey, if I can just will down this Pokemon from the bench. Just, oh, Judge, that may be good, that may be bad, I don't know. But maybe before this thing gets ready, I should try to get a plan B out. Okay. What do we got? We really need the Dimension Valley, which will help technically both of us. So Hoopa comes out. Woo! That's plenty of cards that you're gonna have to discard, but oh, man, you're gonna just dump all your Shamans off. I don't know if I really want to deal with that. That's a lot of Shamans. How many attacks do I need? How many Shamans are there? Two. Calculating. If I want to do something sneaky. We'll just put it that way. I still need plenty of energies. I think if I just leave the stadium on, I can let him keep his bench, and things are gonna get messy. So, I've made up my mind. I'm gonna keep the Dimension Valley up there. But we gotta make sure that we get a plan B up. Alright, so plan B is... I need cards. Let's see, what else is around here? Okay. I got an Ultra Ball. Here we go. And let's see what we got. Do we have the Ultra Ball? Yes, we do. We have only one Dimension Valley up, but energy. I'm gonna finish the magic off with Aegislash. So now I don't need this. I don't need another Dual Blades. Hopefully I can get Sushi Master. Two Sushi Masters, excellent. Now, we gotta slowly burn out the bench down. But once I finish up Bronzor, he's all free to go, which is really bad. Okay. So, I'm gonna dump my hand all again. 14 cards left. Do we even want more cards? Sure. Alrighty then. Now, gonna save that for a little later. Silent Fear. Everybody, take 30 damage. So, one more shot. Oh no, that's a retreat. Oh, I still can pull this off. So Mewtwo is like, I gotta get rid of them before something terrible happens. Something really, really terrible happens. So Shaman will be vulnerable. Oh, I can already see it. Do you see it? Do you see what's coming? Do you? Oh, I just realized I can't attack with this yet. Okay. I can amp damage, which is... Oh man, I guess I really need the stadium right now. Woo! Let's hope that comes out in time. Weakness policy? Mm-mm. Okay, let's dump everything I can. This is mandatory. This is sort of mandatory. Let's go ahead and maximize our chances. Sure, get the burst balloon back, but... I need to pull the stadium. Okay. Oh, the stadium comes out. He gets to discard a bunch of his wounded cards. Ah. Okay. So I'm gonna go ahead and evolve this. I guess I have to. I have to. Trance. Didn't calculate it. That was too soon. I really wanted to knock you out. So. Bronzor goes down, he gets to save that. Shaman. And possibly Shaman. Okay. That means that, well, I get to use Silent Fear at least one more time. We're not gonna see that fantastic finisher, but it's okay. Now, maybe I can send you for one more turn. Psychic Infinity. This is gonna bring you into 120. It will. Aegislash, time to bring the pain. Sword pain. Oh, I pulled into energy. Oh, I should have kept this out here. So I had a choice to do it one more time. Now, let's go ahead and put this on, and we're gonna use the painful sword. Get everybody! Ooh. Okay, two prize guards got rid of the main Mewtwo. Gonna get all the Bronzors out. One. Two. Oh my gosh, and the... Alright, Spirit Link, it's gonna go into Mega Form, but it's gonna be so wounded when it attacks. Trevenant can already finish you off at this point. As long as you don't discard the stadium, that is, because that would really screw me over. No, I could just wait it out. Man, I should have waited another turn for that sword pain. Okay, so if you attack me, you will take 60 damage, and this one energy Silent Fear will finish off the Mewtwo, and I should be good. Oh, I so wanted to miss the sword pain. Wipe out. But it comes to this. So, alright. What you got? Verse Seeker? We'll see. Currently, he may do something that may mess me up, bud. But hold on. Thinking... A judge. That would really mess me up. If I don't pull the energy, that is. You know, I have time. I can just leave Octillery, pull some more cards out. It'll be okay. So, the judge, please. He decides to attack me. Even with the bursting balloon. Silent Fear. Very last attack. That'll be you too. I got you too. Yes. Woo! Alright. Let's move on. Let's move on. You know, in the video game, Aegislash has 9 resistance and 3 immunities. Just one Pokemon. Man, that is some insane defense. Okay, so welcome to another Aegislash Trevenant match. Let's get started and item lock. Oh, he's not gonna be able to rare candy next turn and gonna have to take the long way around. So hopefully a rare candy. Phantom's gonna lock you down. So let's get started. Now I'm gonna go ahead and pull out Rimray, pull out Hone Edge. I'm gonna go with another Phantom. They seem pretty reliable. And, you know, Phantom doesn't really need a double cuz energy. Hone Edge does. So I'm gonna go ahead and attach to him. Toss this down. I don't really need a float zone anyway. I don't need to play this essentially immediately, so let's use Ascension. Sorry, buddy. I hope you played all the items you wanted to, because it's not gonna happen. Unless there's a Lysander, by the way. Actually, I totally forgot about that. So, Sushi Master is out! And automatic victory. Well, sometimes an item lock is just that bad. Oh, that's too short. That wasn't really a match. We're gonna move on! You know, Aegislash has been in shield form for many, many different prints throughout the trading card game. So this is probably one of 2 times that I can think of that he's in blade form. So it's rare Aegislash in that sense. Okay, so welcome to another Aegislash Trevenant match. Let's get started. And now I'm... Actually, I don't have any draw supports. I'm waiting for something. And burst balloons versus Night March. And a Night March which I don't see that's not using the focus or fighting theory belt. So in that case, a bursting balloon will take out this Jolting. And they'll be able to take out Hone Edge. None of my Pokemon can really stand up to this. Man, if the item lock is out now, this would be pretty devastating for him. So I mean, that's what I should have done, because I did go first, but it decided to live ball Octillery, you know, Rimrain. Yeah, so I hope this works. Okay, so just gonna wait, hold, and let's see what he does. It looks like pass, perfect. Wally, beautiful. All right. I'm gonna have to dump my entire hand. So yeah, there's a very good chance Dual Blade isn't gonna survive, but we have to shrink our hand no matter what. And I'm gonna go ahead and use Wally. Get out Sushi Master. And you know, I can play the Equal Arm, but wait one more turn, and I'll be able to get maybe even 2 of these things back. So, Octillery Sushi Master, what can you get for me? Evil Soda and Equal Arm. You know, all I can do is really false swipe, which really sucks in this situation, because it only does 20 damage. So this Joltik, okay, maybe you might get a Fighting Fury belt, ain't gonna work now. And I'll be able to promote you to Aegislash, which will make you tankier. And he's like, no, I'm gonna wait this out, guys. means unless he decides to retreat Joltik, then let's just wait. Not think about that. Worry about that yet. Okay, so these things, he could have knocked this dual blades down, but it's like, what are these bursting balloons doing here? Oh, there are muscle bands. Up, two bursting balloons gone. Okay. And now we have the powerful Aegislash, which cannot do anything at this point. What are we gonna do? We still need more cards. And my Aegislash is relatively vulnerable. Nobody really needs the weakness posse. But I'm gonna go ahead and throw this down. Let's get some of those balloons back. I'm pretty sure they're gonna be annoying in the long run. And what else can we get? Now, what is this? That's not a complete game. But I had another bursting balloon, and the item lock was almost ready to come out. Which, I don't know. I would have KO'd the Joltik next turn with my I can't close this out, but I had the Evo Soda once Trevenant was up. That might be it for him. Because, yeah, could easily close the game pretty soon. Probably. Of course I could. So, Night March taken care of. Let's move on. Okay. I know I said this before, but this is a skinny Duskull who's wearing a teapot on his head. He just switches to mask out. He's pretending to be a phantom. So, this is, yeah. Okay. And, let's get started. Unfortunately, I'm not able to use Ascension my first attack, but that's okay. Oh, is this a Mind Food deck. Alright, can you attack me your first turn? Go ahead, buddy. I dare you. Attack me your first turn, you're gonna lose. So, why not? He can't evolve, and if he puts an energy, he would be able to do zero damage, and it's kind of a waste. But Octillery is here, so you gotta, make room for more cards. And Lucario's coming out. Oh, I'm psychic. I'm gonna deal double damage to that. Awesome. Oh, we both got the Evil Tall skin. Yeah, this is definitely really cool looking. You know, Xerneas is pretty good. Which is better? I don't know. Red, dark. Why am I thinking about this? But of course, he's not gonna charge a mind. Ooh. This is pretty bad. Yep, play all the energies you need, because you're not gonna this might be it for you. Oh, well, we don't even have to use Ascension. We can already, yeah, I can actually attack. Do I want to? Am I able to survive an attack from you? Yeah, I am. Alright, I'm gonna save the Ultra Balls, because I do want to keep this. So, three more cards. Sushi Master was in school last turn, and now he's ready to cook. Okay, here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna discard, unfortunately, an energy, which is gonna be really useful, and a weakness policy, which is already trash. And this way, I can get dual blades up. So, two evolutions going for me. Now, DCE, we're gonna get our first prize card. Knock you out. And, all right, energy. We have, the nightmare is here. He needs to at least two-shot me, but if Trevenant Break comes out... Oh, yeah, it's still two-shot. Somersault Kick. I think it's got this. Man, that muscle band, strong energy, dual blades. I think you have to finish this up. I think that evolving, using one of my Trevenant Breaks may not be enough. So resistance, 80 damage, 30 damage left. I can upgrade it to 80 more damage. No, yeah, it's not going to work. Wait. No, still not enough. But when Aegislash comes up, it will be. So let me go ahead and pull some more cards out. Alright, what are we going to get with this? I think I want to get another Phantom going. That makes sense. So, I'm going to hide Aegislash for now. Because I don't want to burn my energies. But we're going to use the Tree Slam. Get one big hit on it, and man, if there was a burst balloon, this would have finished it.
And even taxing, I'll take you down with me, but...
Yeah, 30 damage. You did a good job, man. You took out a Mindfu, and if he does not have a basic Pokemon, this is gonna be it. One energy, blow these out. And that may be it. If he is this gonna be it? That is it. I want to get it. So now, let's do this. Dual Blades, time to use really overkill attack. Here we go. Now, time to I have a bursting balloon. I'm not gonna risk it. Let me go ahead and throw these two energies off. And we're gonna pull out Aegislash. Here we go, painful sword. And you're gonna have your day, buddy. Throw this on, throw a bursting balloon, throw everything I need. Couldn't resist. Double the damage. And does weakness count? No, it does not. It doesn't matter. Got it. Finished it off. Woo. Lucarios are dangerous. Lucky he started with Mindfu first. Okay, so, gonna move on. You know, Trev's name is pretty easy to figure out where that comes from. Tree. Yeah, right there. The word tree is right there. And Revenant means scary ghost that terrorizes people. Man, that's a little bit creepy. Anyways, and unfortunately, we're starting off with the Honedge, who's looking up in despair against this big dragon, Giratina. I better start doing something. So let me go ahead, grab out Rimmerade. And man, Evil Soda's up here. Okay, this thing is expensive. It should not be able to finish me off. So let me go ahead and get one of everything. You know, because I got Evil One Evil Soda for you, one for you. That'd be good. And then we'll Birch. Yeah, I think I'm good. I'm gonna wait. And if I get a DCE, we could really put a lot of hurt on this thing. But starting off with a Honedge in front is not very ideal. And really, I'd rather get an Iron Lock on. So maybe I should get retreat him, but we'll see. 100 damage, 110, ooh, you can barely survive one attack. And if Chaos Wheels goes into effect. Wow, Poke Tools, I can't put Poke Tools. Ugh, special energies. Okay, I have 4 special energies. This would be very bad if Chaos Wheel went into effect. So let's hope that will not come to that. I need to set up much faster. Ultra Ball! Why would you throw Shaman and Sycamore? Wow. That must be quite a hand. Alright, it is Seismitoad and Giratina right off the bat. Okay, so if he has retreat, DCE, that'd be bad. But that's... Okay, DCE. I'm the wrong guy. Silence Valley? Oh, that's what you need. Silent Valley. That's a mixture of Silent Lab and Dimension Valley. We're definitely gonna discard that. But once this thing attacks, I'm really gonna be in trouble. So, Birch, you gotta pull this off for me. So this is one turn. Crushing Hammer? No, this is so annoying. But wait, I have an annoying deck of my own. So, this is definitely gonna work out. Okay. And Ultra Ball Team Fleet. Yep, I got no EX Pokemon whatsoever. Good move there. And man, that's a lot of Ultra Balls. That's all your Ultra Balls, probably. Another frog. I don't want to see these frogs. We're definitely going to discard that. There's a chance the Double Dragon Energy comes on. I definitely need Sushi Master. I definitely need Trevenant. I do not have faith on this Honedge, so I'm not gonna evolve you. Which is probably a smart move, right? I'm gonna Birch. Birch, do you love me? He's like, no. I knew it, so that's why I was totally saving Octillery. Go ahead and toss you down. Oh, I can put my item lock on. You're using plenty of items, right? Yeah, yeah. Item locks up. Gonna put this just for safe measures in case he locks me up. I won't be able to play the card. And we got Skyla, which I can't play, but if I do, if he does not lock me up with any items, judge. Ooh, thank you! 4 cards for you, 4 cards for me, and I have way too many energies in that hand. I need a Trevenant break. And a Dual Blades. Okay. We got a Dual Blades. We got a Trevenant break. We can start putting the hurt on. And yeah, we'll go ahead and definitely gonna put this back on you. Now, Skyla, what do I really need? Did I actually put this on Dual Blades? I didn't mean to do that. I'm gonna grab an Evil Soda, guys. I need some soda. Yeah, let's go ahead and grab this. And I don't think I'll be able to play it this turn. I guess it's lit up, so it means I can. In that case, I should have done that. Here we go, Evil Soda. And we're gonna get a second Dual Blades out. Now, this is definitely good evil. This is definitely good fodder for Ultra Ball. So I'm gonna save that. I'm gonna save everything. We're gonna use Silent Fear. Get the hurt going. All right. Lots of items have been played. I need three more attacks so I can vanquish this entire hand. I'm not completely set up though. Cause I have, why'd you remove that? Oh, I probably should have played these and dumped these. Three more cards. That makes sense. He didn't really need to play Roxic, but yeah. Oh, he had an enhanced hammer, but he's stuck. I think he's stuck. Victory! That was it! That's like the first two matches of this video, early matches. Item lock is really powerful. Really, really, really powerful. If you get that thing out early, you won. Pretty much. Okay, so. What happens when you have two decks trying to item lock each other? Really bad time. Now, welcome to the final round of the tournament. It's been going on for a while. Didn't catch it at the start because I didn't realize I pressed the record button. So, anyways, nobody has taken any prize cards. We have tried to lock each other out, and this is the results. He has been, well, to keep you up to date, knocking all my energies away. So I haven't been able to attack him at all, which sucks. And he is gonna finish off the first Trevenant. And I can't play most of my items. But, Trevenant, you're good to go. And how are we gonna do this? All right, since I can't play any items, I can't really do anything except Tree Slam or Silent Fear. I'm gonna Tree Slam, because this is gonna take four hits to work on this guy, and it's gonna take four hits to get me down. And we'll slowly work on the shame, but man, I really just have to pull the right cards, because I cannot use my items, and this means I'm stuck. Now, I've won Birch. Yeah, so we're both in a pretty bad position. Oh, he's trying to go for the Grenade Hammer. Oh man, if he gets another item, this... Oh, he just... He decided not to attack me. But that, if you don't attack me, that means that I get to use my items, which I will gladly do. So, he made a misclick right there. But you gotta do what you gotta do. So, alright. I wanna dump all my items so I can get something up. And who needs a weakness policy? I guess you can, because I need some pull draw power. Here we go, two more cards. What will they be? Another energy. I'm gonna save that because I know he has discard, so we're gonna use Tree Slam again. And it's his turn. Once again, I'm stuck, and he decided. Oh! He got the stadium! Is healing himself, so I. Nope, probably wasn't disconnect. He just decided not to attack me. Alright, Lysander gonna pull the guy with the float stone out and finish him off. Uh oh. Okay. Super scoop up. Oh! And he picks the shaman up. That's how he wanted to free himself from the item lock. Got it. I thought he was gonna pick up the frog. Was like, oh, darn, drats. But hey, we can almost finish this frog up. Judge? I guess that makes, wait. Oh, He's just dumping Verse Seeker after Verse Seeker, because you're not going to get any chances to use your items after he knocks out the Dual Blade. Okay, so this is sort of bad. Team Flare Grunt. This is why I'm holding on with my energies. This is looking bad. So, I'm going to get one energy discarded. That's why I was holding on to that. Now, let's go ahead and send you back out again. And we're going to displace that stadium. And there's no reason to tell him that I had this energy. Or, yeah, let's just go ahead and do it, because I need to make sure that my draws are up to date. And here we go. Tree Slam. Two more Tree Slams should do it, because this Muscle Band is making him super tough. All right, go ahead, discard the energy. I'll be fine. But, or please do judge, though. If you have that card, we're locked up. Let's see, if he has the Grenade Hammer, he can really quickly finish off my Trevenant. But he doesn't know. Maybe I have Aegislash to finish it off. Sycamore, ooh. Didn't go for the discard? Oh, that was a waste of an energy then. Smart. Ish. Okay, now 2-3 frogs are down. This is tough for both of us, I'm sure, because both our items decks are probably loaded with items. 40 damage. Ooh, if you get that water energy, I'm dead next turn. Oh, hey, I can get another Trevenant lock going. And we're going to Tree Slam. That sounds safe. Everybody takes some damage. So one more hit. You should be finished off if I can get that last hit off. I sure hope so. And he hid this energy for the Grenade Hammer. Okay, I need a DCE. Nobody has a free retreat. Oh man, he should get the next... Oh, he broke the item lock. Okay. Maybe we can do something about that. Alright, now, let me go ahead, try and dump all the items I can, because, well, this is the only chance I have. Now, this thing gets Poke Tools. Have I been using Poke Tools, really? Doesn't matter, I need to empty my hand. Is this gonna work? I hope so. Nope, it looks like I don't have to use Ascension, but I'm gonna put the lock back on him. He can attack me, but he'll be item locked for at least one turn. Now, I think that he won't use an item lock effect. He'll just try to knock me out, maybe. Okay, but I'm not gonna risk anything. Let's just go ahead, get the float stone back. Make sure everybody has retreat. I think that's good. So, maybe he may not choose not to attack me, or I don't know. He only has 10 hit points left. Man, this is a bad time to be low on energies. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, he's been discarding him. 4, 5, 6. I don't have that many left, and he's trying to get another Seismitoad up. Ooh, Sycamore. Ooh, 10 cards left in your deck. Maybe I gotta outlast him. How many Sycamores have been played? At this point, you're probably not gonna play another Sycamore. But the unlock is still in effect. How many Trevenants I got? Ooh, I think I'm out of Trevenants. Oh, he decides not to item lock me. Okay. Let me go ahead and grab. It's a DCE. Alright, so a lot of frogs are gonna get hurt in this next turn. Now, I know that I have no more Trevenants, which is why I'm gonna get some of my energies and at least one Trevenant back. So, there we go. You've been discarding it. So let me get them back. And here we go. We got the DCE. Are we gonna Birch? Is there something I really need? Oh yes, I really want the Trevenant. Birch, have you been Tails all day? Are you gonna change your mind? Like, yeah, sure, but are you gonna give me something amazing? Not bad. Now, I am afraid of item locks, so I'm gonna definitely dump everything I can. Alright, you know, I may need this one burst balloon. Man, an energy. Okay. I think this is all I can do. I'm gonna use the Painful Sword. I hope he does not discard something, but if I can get one more hit in, we'll be good. Got one energy, maybe discarding energy was a bad idea since I was low in the first place. Should be okay though. They're somewhere. I will get two frogs back here. They're 160. Heals them up. Okay. Replaces. Oh, the stadium. That's gonna heal 30 off. Oh, shoot. And scoop up. Oh, yeah, the item lock's in effect. No, don't knock it off. It's got knocked off. What a comeback. Oh. And another energy comes on, the lock goes into effect. Shaman, six cards left, but man, what a tough counter. Okay, I'm item locked, and if he gets one more energy, he'll can possibly knock me out. All right, what to do? You know, how many DCEs have I used up? I probably think I've used up all of them. Yeah. Here's for wishful thinking. If you survive one more turn, we can at least can get one frog off. But this frog is gonna be completely healed. This one, whoo! He's like, yes, free turn. If I got an energy, do you have an energy, buddy? I hope not, because if that's so, I may be able to last the five turns necessary. And Cassius pulls them all back home. No! Quaking Punch. Okay, so now I can use Painful Sword, hurt one of those guys. I think, well, that's what I have to do. So, here we go. Dimension Valley. Gonna go ahead and replace your stadium. It's a little too late, but I'm in attack mode. Wait, I can get another of something, which is not gonna be what I need this turn. So, Painful Sword, zero damage, and we are trying to finish this frog back here off. Okay. And how many turns can I... two more hits. So I may not be able to finish this frog off, which sort of sucks. Oh, discarded my stadium. And I have to just... wait, this... I really have to discard? Whew, well, I guess I don't need these cards. I won't be able to play them. Four cards, five cards. We are both really low in cards. And he puts the stadium back up. Oh, man. And Quaking Punch again. Pulled me something amazing. It's a birch. That's... well, see what I can get. Well, an energy. So, I'm gonna use Painful Sword once again. Get him to 100 damage. And he can heal this off to 70. And this allows him almost. Oh. Oh no. Quaking Punch. He got me. GG. That's it. I'm gonna birch. Maybe live one more turn. Well, that's it. No more cards. Stadium. It ruined my chances, but I saw it. There was a light was there. I just couldn't touch it. So, time for the last part of the video. Let's get to that. Well, congratulations. You sort of made it to the end. Don't look at the video. But, I think it's time that you rate the deck. And I think this is a B-. Mainly due to Aegislash. Okay, so, why? Well, Aegislash can be devastating. If the damage counters aren't there, and he has plenty of bench Pokemons, then if they're wounded, Painful Sword, which you saw during the first match, can obliterate everything if there's damage. If it's being healed off by, say, Soothing Seas, or any other source, Painful Sword does nothing. Aegislash value just goes down dramatically, which is pretty bad. So I think Gengar is gonna be better, because if I had Gengar for that fight and maybe the fight which you may see, easy job. Now, Trevenant is the real deal here. You saw that when Trevenant starts up first, sometimes that may be it. Your opponent may just quit. I'm done. And you saw what happened when I was item blocked. It's a pretty big deal. It's dangerous, but you get by. This deck got by enough. The Seismitoad deck got by enough and got me in the end. But it just shows you how strong item locks are. All right, so what's up for next time, Don? I think it's gonna be Ninetales. The new EX card, which, it's a typical EX, but we're gonna try it anyway. So, why is there video length left? I don't know, but if you really wanna see a Ho-Oh match, that'd be coming up next. Yeah, so I'll hold off my goodbyes for now. But if you're tired, see you next time, Integrals and Differentials, for Ninetales. Bye bye. You know, Aegislash, in attack form, has the highest special attack of all the non-legendaries. While in defensive form, it has the best special defense of all the ghosts. So, yeah, that's one crazy Pokemon. Okay, so welcome to another Aegislash Trevenant match, where this time we're going to be starting off with, unfortunately, Honedge. We'll see how this goes. So, this deck looks... This is not Vivalion, is it? It's something else. It's Togekiss version. Ooh, okay! So, a big giant bird. It's like, I can take this. Alright, we'll see about that. Now, Bridget, the best supporter. Start off with first. Now, Smeagol here. Okay, can change code. What energies have he discarded? Pretty much every of the three energy he needs. So with Recoat, anything can happen. Are you gonna go home or are you gonna take the spits? And it's like, no, send the Ho that can heal itself up. Send it out. All right, so let's see. We got Pumpkaboo. Let's go ahead and get the whole shebang out. You. One of everything. Maybe even two Sushi Masters. One of everything's fine. Okay. Now, I can't evolve any of my Pokemons yet. You can't attack yet, right? You know, there's a chance Togekiss may come out. I'm gonna go ahead and toss this down, which would be like, psh, it's a waste. And just to be safe, I'm not gonna be bold, charge up the front Honedge. Although, that might be spectacular when you put this thing down to one hit points. But we'll see. You can just like, I'm just gonna wait this out. That's a little risk with Bursting Balloon. So, Sushi Master is out, and Togekiss variant. Alright, if Togepi and Togetic come out, this thing could pretty much go be ready. The only problem I see is that if you have Battle Compressor, you're taking energies out your deck, which is, means it's not gonna hit with Togetic, which is right there. Yeah, alright. What is got? Trainer Mail. In the mail, there is, the Fighting Fury Belt. So this thing is gonna go upgrade itself to 220 hit points. We're gonna have to do a lot of work, especially that it's healing itself at 50 every turn. So maybe we can try to knock out these guys back here, but we really need Fantip to go up. All right, there is the Togetic and Sushi Bastards. I'm ready for Sushi Man. Four more guards. Unless he can play this last card. Nope. Ooh, it's like, they're, now they're staring at each other, and it's like, that Sushi Master, he's way ahead of me right now, so please, you gotta do something about that, man. So he's like, don't worry, I got you, just you wait. I hope you can do this, man, I hope you can do this. And now, with Smeagol, he can really attack if he just gets two energies on. So one more energy, and that is going to be enough. Or maybe you can just attack me this turn. It's a Sycamore. But this energy is not a Togetic energy. And that's a lot of energies in your discard already. Okay, but it doesn't really matter because you can get whichever you like. It just means that Togetic has a higher chance to miss. Now, Bursting Balloon went off, unfortunately, without bursting. It's more like a dud balloon. Now, three more cards. Please be amazing. I can put an item lock on him this turn. In which... I'm not even ready to attack, so I'm gonna hold off on that. We are just simply going to use the Ultra Ball. I don't need the Super Rod. I think I can just play Wally this turn, so we're gonna go ahead and throw away this. And what do I need? I need Trevenant to come up. And Trevenant, it should be able to, Trevenant Break should be able to survive one attack. So let's go ahead and play this. I already have Trevenant Break. You just hang in there, Hone Edge. And let's grab out Dual Blades. Yeah, get both evolutions lying at the same time. And next turn, big sushi. I'll end my turn. Maybe I should just go out and false wipe them. Your 210 hit points is gonna go all the way down to one. If it's head, that's a big if. And there's the final energy he needs to attack. Smeagol is like, oh, wait, no it's not. You need lightning energy. I'm gonna recoat that. And poor Hone Edge is gonna take a big blast. Now he needs to play Lysander and get one of these cards out. And I need an energy. Togekiss? Alright, remember what I said about the energies? You know, chance, luck is luck. He has got 15 cards left in his deck. Cyrene Grace, maybe we see two Ho-Ohs come up. Ooh, this is gonna be rough. And the lightning energy goes on to second Ho. Only one. And he is definitely gonna recoat. And now, Donald, you gotta make a choice. Who you wanna send up? You know, I think we'll wait to make his debut. Yeah, I think that's gonna be the best. So, I need the Dimension Valley, and I need an energy. Otherwise, this could be a waste, and I would really have to send Dual Blade. So, he's got two energies on with the recoat, that doesn't really matter. And the item lock wasn't out in time. Could really slow this deck down. Oh, that's just what you have to deal with. Okay. Just waiting. He's waiting. This is the saddest Hone Edge of all. That was sad. He's looking up, why me? Why me? And then, ooh. What are you going for? Oh, my Trevenant. Oh, you're going to get an extra prize card for that. That's not good. I'm going to block your items for sure. And... alright, we got Aegislash. I pulled into an Aegislash. I really want a Trevenant to save my Pokemon so he doesn't get an extra prize card. So, Sushi Master cooks me up 5 more cards. What can you get for me? Exactly what I need. Dimension Valley, we're going to send it up. Unfortunately, we'll not be able to save this Trevenant. Okay, so, Silent Fear. Everybody take 30 damage. And 140, I can still survive. We're waiting for you, buddy. Hopefully you can just blast everyone and send them all flying. Now, with the setup, he doesn't have a fire energy up. They're all in his discard, so he is not able to heal this up. I think. Unless he decides to recoat. The energy was on this thing. He's not able to recoat. He's like, make my day. I'm waiting, man. I know you are. So, where's the next energy gonna go into? You know what, I think I'm just gonna Silent Fear, but... this is tough. I wish I could come out and do a Megaton Slash or something. Or use a Max Potion at this point. Definitely, maybe I should add those in. So 140, ouch! What should I do? Should I just use my front attack? Okay. I'm gonna go ahead, put this on you. We're gonna be forced. Yeah, I definitely need the carpools, and I want to get another Trevenant breakup. So, we're not done softening it, is what I'm saying. We're not done softening up his team. More cards, come on Trevenant break. The rest of the gang is still in here, okay. Hmm. Okay, this is maybe all I can do. No, we can still have an evolution. We can still pull off. We can still pull off a second Aegislash to come out. Okay. The final Silent Fear. And I think this may be it. And he may get another Phantom. Maybe I really shouldn't have thrown that one down. Who knows? Who knows? But I can see what I can should do. We're going to use two Aegislashes, two swords, and try to finish this up. Now, he's going to put in energy. He is definitely going to try to heal it up. At least keep one of the Ho-Ohs alive. Just one. So, oh, this is going to really dramatically reduce the damage from the front Ho-Oh. But will I may be able to destroy all these guys back here? Is that going to be enough prize cards? No. So Pokemon Center Lady, oh, completely heals him up. He knows he's in danger. So I have to scratch one. I'm only going to get four prize cards. I'm already counting them. Yeah. Okay, we can definitely evolve you with a Skyla next turn. Woo! No, I'm not going to even survive one attack from you anyways. So good luck getting those prize cards down. We still have some time. And let's see, I need Evil Soda. I definitely need an Evil Soda or Wally. Oh, Evil Soda, please, I need exactly the soda. Ooh, a Bursting Balloon. You know, I haven't pulled any of the four of those yet. Where were they? But hopefully with the next sushi, he'll cook me up some of those. All right. We're gonna get Aegislash. Oh, not you. No, don't attack yet, buddy. This isn't the right energy card. Let's just go ahead and toss you on. There, Sushi Master, you can have it. No, not even gonna put this on you. Ooh. Exactly what I needed. Rimraid, I really want to toss you down. Can I evolve you? Well, there is a chance. I will have to toss you down next turn, just not this turn. So we're going to use the Painful Sword, double everybody's damage. There goes your Sushi Master. One prize card. A Psychic Energy, definitely what I need. Now, he is able to heal this off, but this thing will wound him. And he can't heal that off immediately. So the next sword is going to go pretty hard. All right, we got Trevenant Break. We're not too afraid of the bench damage. The second Ho-Oh, come on. No, there's no way you can charge that one up. No. Purifying Fire? Yes, that's right. But when you attack, maybe you want to switch. Okay, Lysander. Maybe it's Lysander. I don't know. You're running very low on cards. It's AZ. Gonna completely heal somebody up. Probably this Ho-Oh. And that's a lot of energies down. Now, I'm getting a little worried that if I can't really burst this down, but we'll see what we can do. So, Max Elixir. Man, there shouldn't be that many energies left in your F. They're all in the discard. Woo! Fighting Fury Bell. Okay. So, this is the only guy we gotta worry about. Alrighty. So, attack me. Bursting Balloon. I'm not gonna survive. I know, that's a shame. Should I use my Trevenant to attack? Trevenant Break will be able to finish it off and hit these guys back here. Okay, we're gonna have to use Trevenant Break. So here we go. Go into your break form. Let's go ahead and toss everybody out. And I'm gonna go ahead and throw this down here. Throw the weakness policy. I'll just dump it on you. You already have a free retreat. And merch or sushi? Let's get some sushi. Alright. Didn't get anything, so we're gonna birch. Birch heads! Awesome! Another bursting balloon. Definitely want this on here. And now, I'm gonna use Silent Fear. Go ahead and soften everybody up into. Oh, got a prize card. Awesome! Four more to go. Man, how am I gonna get you down? Because once you're down, that's it. That's it for you. I've used up all my DCEs. Purifying Flame. Alright, that's... Ooh. That's gonna get you pretty close. A Painful Sword is not gonna quite finish you off. Oh, I think he's got this. Maybe. 100 damage. That's not quite enough. Man, if only it didn't have this thing, we'd be okay. But I'm just gonna wait. Wait a minute. Okay. I think I may see something. I need another bursting balloon, definitely, for sure. But it is really countering this purifying flame, which sort of sucks. So, four prize cards. Let's see what you can do. Who are you gonna attack? My Aegislash. Yeah, definitely go for you. Hopefully, it's not prized. So now, I can't quite finish you off with my Aegislash. I may have to hit you with a Force Curse. Okay, let's do this. Let me go ahead, grab out Sushi Master, so we can go ahead and evolve you. And there we go. Nobody can really evolve at this point, so I really just want to shrink my hand. There is nobody left, I know that. Put the final energy on you. And I don't know, if you heal this off, you can only heal 50, right? Alright. In that case, we're gonna use the Tree Slam. This will make sure you get knocked out. Of course I'm gonna get the second guy, just in case. So, there we go. Okay. One prize guard left. But there's no way he can save this. Ooh! He can get all the energies to attack on Ho-Oh! And he's gonna heal himself. One prize card left. Oh! Too many prize cards to go. Wait a minute. If I had taken both these Smeagles down with me, that may have been enough. Okay, just gonna wait and see.
Not even gonna let you see the end of that. Painful Sword did take out Ho-Oh and Smeagol. But he finished me first, because curse healing saved this, but man, I couldn't pull it off. Well, until next time, Integrals and Differentials. I'll see you back in my kitchen for Ninetales, that fox, yes. Let's see how that one goes.